Alright everyone, I just wanted to make a quick little video talking about my man Max here, and his video streaming has messed me up because I just found it so relatable. Even though I'm a nobody, you know, my videos aren't doing well or anything, and he gets 10 to 15,000 viewers a stream, what he's talking about, it just amazes me. Like, doesn't matter if you're a, you know, massive or you're like a tiny YouTuber streamer like myself. The problems are still there, and the issues he's discussing, and he's basically, he's talking about Elden Ring. I'll link the video so you can watch it, but he's talking about that he's allowed to play Elden Ring to do like a network test a few days earlier before there's a beta or something, and he's really struggling to like start up the game because he's got to play it by himself. Like, he's just in a room by himself, and he's saying how for most people that's a good thing, you know, whether if your life's hectic, you know, work or family life's hectic, games are an escape, you put the headset on or whatever and you just dive into the world or whatever world you're gonna jump into and you get to escape. And he was talking about how streaming, because he's been doing it for like 8+ years, like, he finds it hard to stream, to play games when there's no social aspect to it, you know, there's no chat there to engage with. And I just found it so relatable, because as soon as you become a content creator and you upload that first video, you're hoping for social engagement, you know, you're hoping for feedback, you're hoping for views, you're hoping for comments, you're hoping that people like it, you know, and it, the longer you do it, the more it becomes natural, you know, that it's the way you play games, you know, you no longer play games just for you to dive into this world and escape, you know, because even if it's a YouTube video which isn't live, you're still pretending to talk to someone. So when they see it, when you upload it, so in your head there's still a social aspect to it, and then you know you're going to upload it, so there's a social aspect, like, you know, you're making a YouTube video, and the longer you do it, I say it becomes commonplace. So what happened to me was, I always made a rule that if I didn't feel like making a video, if I didn't want to fake enthusiasm, what I would do is just not play, and that became counterproductive, because if I was doing a playthrough or something, what I would normally do is I would play for 3-4 hours and say 20 minutes of video, so that's like 9 to 12 parts, and so that would usually be good for like a while and buy me like a buffer time, you know. But of course, you don't want to over flood your YouTube channel with like 4 videos a day unless you're like the Rad Brad or some shit. But so I would want to play, but I couldn't play because I was doing a playthrough, so the only option would be to start the game again and play through what I've already played through. So it became this kind of balance of when I wanted to play, but I couldn't play, and then I had to make videos, but I didn't want to fake the enthusiasm, and then it just became this weird, like, I don't know, fucking fight to always be in the right situation. And then, it's like anything else though, he was trying to say like maybe a lot of people won't understand this, and I was like, nah man, plenty of people will get this, because it's like anything else, it's like watching a comedy special on Netflix, and say you're watching it by yourself, and then say you bring around a couple of mates to watch it, but then say you bring around a couple of mates who have a few beers to watch it, it raises the, you know, the energy in the room and the enhancement, the enjoyment of it. So Max has been streaming like 5 days a week for 8 years. Of course that's going to take like a toll on the way you perceive games, you know, like that social interaction between you, the game, and the chat. And I say it can even happen to content creators, and when you look, as in just YouTubers, because I mean if you look, it's just a plethora of like guys with the old check marks, you know, all talking about, like, they go through the same thing, you know. Whereas this guy, he says, playing for fun and playing to entertain others isn't always the same. I find myself struggling to play games unless I'm recording. While recording, you're putting your best into it as much as possible for the viewing experience. It's very hard to turn that off for me, which is why I don't even play video games unless it's for work. You know, I think it's a very, very common thing for streamers and YouTubers alike that go through this process of the games. It's no longer just about you and the game. It becomes about you, the game, and the social experience. And then there's also, which I think ties into this, is the fear of missing content. The fear of, for me anyway, it was, I started recording because whenever something cool would happen, I would want to show my friends. but I couldn't. I was like, you know, whenever you go to your mate, you go, oh, do you see that? Did you see that? And they'd be like, nah, man. And you're like, fuck. So that's where it started for me. I started to do that because I wanted people to see it. But then that starts this thing in your mind of like, content creation is always there. You know, you're always like, got to make a video. Am I making a video? And then recording becomes the norm rather than recording being the exception. Like, you play normally, just game, and then occasionally you'll make videos. And now it's, I'll make videos all the time, and then playing the game, like, just for yourself becomes, like, the minority. And I can totally see what he's talking about. Anyway, I'll link, as I say, if I did say, I'll link this video but so you can watch it yourself, but I totally feel for you, Max. Like, this is very, very normal. And I still struggle with it, even though I don't make videos as much as I used to, because I've been at it for 8 years. 8 years I've been doing it, and I still struggle with it. And I'm tiny, tiny YouTuber. You know, I'm always thinking, oh, should I record this? Should I record this? But now I'm, for the last 6-9 months, I would say, I've been getting into just playing the game for me. You know, just getting back to that original enjoyment of what made me love gaming so much in the first place, and not thinking so much about content first or like that social aspect first. You know, of like, I've got to stream or something. Because I don't stream a lot, like, as is, and it's gotten even less because of this exact situation. Plus, I have an anxiety disorder, so that's just part. I mean, that's just not a good combo for a streamer. But Max, hats off to you for bringing this up. I think many like content creators also have this issue. I wouldn't worry about it, mate. You just got to find that balance as best as you can. Maybe take some time off, you know, take a month off, see if you can find games. Or maybe even if you do stream, maybe you can do like a Switch or something. And maybe like late at night or something, you want to just relax for a little bit. Just sit down on the couch with a Switch or something, kind of try and train your brain. You know, going back to just that enjoyment for yourself. You know, you dive into the world alone as opposed to you and 15,000 viewers. Anyway, that's all I wanted to talk about, and I'll see you on the next one.